pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, graduating seniors, teachers, parents, family members, and distinguished guests, and welcome to the graduation of the Tech Valley High School class of 2020. This is a unique graduation ceremony held at an unprecedented time. While we cannot physically be together, this is a celebration of our community, which has worked in concert to help our graduates prepare for the next stage in their lives. Thank you for all you have done to help these students. In his poem, To a Mouse, the Scottish poet Robert Burns describes the terror of a mouse whose home he destroyed while plowing a field. Here's the famous second-to-last stanza translated from Burns's dialect into modern English. The best-laid schemes of mice and men often go awry and leave us nothing but grief and pain instead of promised joy. We hadn't planned for the year to end like this, at home celebrating the achievements of our seniors. We had planned to be together, giving this moment the literal pomp and circumstance that it deserves. It isn't fair, and it's even a little bit cruel to keep us from each other on such a special occasion. A virus, about a tenth of a micron large, has reminded us how easily our plans can go awry. It is how we respond when our plans go haywire that really defines who we are. I would remind you of a couple of things as you plan your response. First, remember that our perspectives are really, really limited. This moment, which has been so disruptive, is a fractional portion of your time on this earth. You've got a lot left to see, a lot left to do, and a lot left to figure out. As the astronomer Carl Sagan said, somewhere, something incredible is waiting to be known. The second thing I'd remind you is that adaptability is always going to be an important tool in your arsenal. The world is ever changing. Preparing for it is a little like trying to hit a moving target. You've got to aim ahead of where the target is if you hope to hit it. It's the reason we stress soft skills just as much as the content skills at Tech Valley High. Things like self-direction, communication, collaboration, technology, and information literacy might be called soft skills, but I think you all know that they couldn't be harder to achieve. The good thing about them is that they're going to be important no matter your task. Finally, I would remind you to keep your sense of humor intact. You'll find that your ability to laugh and make others laugh, which I know you all have, is a superpower that shields you from the painful things that can happen in life. Though our best laid plans have gone awry, graduates, please know that this day belongs to you. I speak for the entire staff of Tech Valley High School when I say that we are extraordinarily proud of you. Congratulations to the historic class of 2020, and good luck on your future endeavors.
So we're here, and we aren't. And I'm not going to tell you this is how I would have chosen to end high school, and I'm sure you feel the same. But I think this situation isn't totally empty of room to learn. Even as we leave high school behind, and we are still graduating, there may be no traditional ceremony, but we have earned this. We have all worked for 4 years to get here, and even though here isn't a physical location this year, it matters just as much. So we're here and we aren't. What can we learn from that? Well, I for one have learned over 4 years that everyone in this class is resilient. We have adapted to change and we have been passionate advocates for it. We have fought for our friends and learned to accept when they've left us. This year, we proved our ability to adapt when we became the first class at Tech Valley High School to finish school online. 4 years of growth prepared us to accept this change, and we have done something that may have seemed impossible freshman year. We have completed our senior projects through Zoom and said our goodbyes through email. We could have given up, but we stayed the course. We completed this year despite the mountain of reasons not to, and we can all be proud of the work we've done. I think one of the last things we can learn from Tech Valley is that we have done the work and we are ready. We'll graduate like no class before us, but we will still graduate. And the struggle we've gone through to get here has only made us more resilient. If we can do this, then we can handle whatever the world throws our way. We're here to graduate, and we've reached this point in all the ways that matter. I want to thank all the teachers, family members, and staff that have helped us get here. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I cannot believe 4 years have passed, and it's time to say goodbye to my classmates and teachers. Although this year has been a roller coaster ride, and not what I envisioned my senior year of high school to be like, I have been blessed with many fun and kind memories of my peers and teachers. Reflecting on these memories can definitely see how much we've all grown as students and as human beings. I am grateful for my experience here at Tech Valley, and I'm so happy to have been graduating with such awesome group of people. I cannot wait to see the next chapters of our lives have in store for us. Graduation is not our end, and it's only our beginning. Jesse, of all my relationships, ours have been the most fun. From the first encounter of you wanting to punch me in the face, to now looking forward to seeing you every day, thank you for taking the time to getting to know me and supporting me along the way. Maeve, our relationship has been rocky, but you have been an inspiration as you continue to push through even when things were hard. May you continue to be unstoppable and strong. Carrie, you will do great things in your life. Your determination and encouragement are very motivating. Thank you. Mackenzie, as you strive to be the best you can be and put 100% effort into the things you do, you always found time to help us with our math and science. I respect your hard work ethic and appreciate the way you have helped me along the way. Lily, you will forever be etched in my mind for the caring and loving person you are. Thank you for always having a smile on your face, even at 8 a.m. Marie, thank you for opening your arms when we needed a hug and for giving good advice. Mylia, thank you for coming out of your shell and showing us how amazing and caring you can be. You will do amazing things, and I cannot wait to see you on the cover of a magazine. Elise, thank you for being there to talk to us and granting us the gift of a lunchies. We'll be needing that. Skylar, thank you for being the lively, spunky girl we always see at 8:10 a.m. Talia, thank you for bringing art and your fun Halloween costumes to our school. You may have missed a year, but you managed to fit right in with the group. Mary Rose, a big shout out to you for all the free hugs and advice you've given. I will miss this the most as we move on in our lives. I'm sure our paths will cross again when I see you on the cover of a women's empowerment magazine. Will and Kareem, I couldn't think of a better duo than you two. We may not have known what you two were giggling about in the back of the room during class, but you guys were the sweetest and most hilarious best friends we've all met. Alfred, I appreciate you for all your cat-themed paraphernalia throughout the years. So too, I have enjoyed the slick comments you would toss in. Riker, thank you for having the courage to always be devil's advocate and unafraid of the consequences of a good challenge. Jack, thank you for keeping the teachers happy by knowing the answers. You've saved us a lot throughout the years. Ian, thank you for being the guy who would always help us with our tech issues, and of course your impressive Rubik's Cube skills. Patrick Logston, we admire how much you've come out of your shell, allowing us to watch your personal growth and confidence. Patrick Leinfelder, thank you for showing us how to accept and embrace our differences. Anthony, thank you for showing us wrestling moves throughout the years and giving us a good laugh when we needed it the most. Alex, thank you for your rad video editing and photos you've done. Andrew, thank you for being the kid who would get his work done with no questions asked. It really helped. And Josh, thank you for keeping the class alive with all the random jokes and asks you've done throughout the years.
Well, hello. I had a better speech than this one, but Hillary deleted it. So this is what I have for you. And don't forget, you asked for this. You asked for a speech from someone who may or may not be wearing pants right now. I'll start by saying that I received an email from Dr. Niedermeyer that read, "Congratulations, the seniors have voted to ask you to provide the staff address at graduation." When I read it, I really didn't believe it because I can't even win on a $2 scratch-off ticket, let alone a popularity contest. It made me think. I wasn't sure at first if I was chosen because you actually liked me, or as I picture it, you're all at home laughing at me because now I have to overcome my fear of public speaking, which I could totally see from your group. But after more thought, it came to me that if your mindset was in any way vindictive, we can all probably agree that there are better choices than me. Much better choices than me. Either way, now your parents, family, and loved ones have to sit through me poorly coming up with words, so I apologize to all the guests out there. I suppose me delivering the staff address might give you some insight on what our faculty members have gone through the last 4 years. Anyway, an address such as this is usually given by a person who has a long list of achievements and success. But in reality, those accomplishments or successes really depend on your own view of what your goals are and who you want to be. I know how this class thinks, so don't twist those last words into an excuse to lower the bar and live like Matt Foley, eating a steady diet of government cheese and living in a van down by the river. But with that being said, success isn't necessarily measured by riches or changing the world, but more so by finding your passion and making a positive difference. Now, I come from a very educationally minded family. Between my three older siblings and my parents, they hold 7 bachelor's degrees, a master's, and a doctorate from various good schools. And then there's me. So when I started to write this, I thought back to when I was in your shoes and looking into my future. I wasn't really sure that I even wanted to go to college. However, I knew it was expected of me. But I was an 18-year-old, I was insecure, I was very nervous. But what I've learned is that sometimes your insecurities and your inexperience may lead you to embrace other people's expectations or their standards or their values. But you'll need to harness that inexperience to carve your own path, a path that is defined by you and your set of reasons. I personally ended up in the math program in a small New Hampshire school. And while I was attempting to find my path, I knew I wanted to do something with math, but I wasn't sure what. The funny thing about it is I actually ended up in the education program to make sure that I had a backup plan. And throughout the course of the next 4 years, I realized I loved it, was passionate about it, and wanted to pursue it. And with that one choice in my first fall semester, it helped me define who I am as a person. I was very fortunate to have found my passion early on, and I understand that that's not the case for everyone. You may have multiple roadblocks before you find the right path. But part of how you define yourself, though, is what you define failure as. It is not a thing. Failure is not a thing if it leads you to your success. It's all part of that journey, that path. You have to appreciate those moments because what happens right after you feel like you've failed is who you are and who you will continue to be. Don't be scared to keep throwing darts at that dartboard because eventually something will stick. Now that you're all graduating and moving on into different areas of study, work, or even travel, I would like to share a quote from a famous writer and composer, Justin Timberlake. He stated, "You have to dare yourself to suck. You have to dare yourself to suck." And if you think about that, what he means by it is that you'll never make anything or do something great if you're afraid that it's going to suck, that it's going to fail. Never be afraid of that because you can always build on those moments. I'd like to leave you by saying whatever perseverance and inspiration got you here to this point, keep it, love it. It's important. Thank you, class of 2020, for breaking my losing streak. Thank you.
take a moment to thank everybody, from my teachers to my family to my friends, for helping me get this far. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Anthony, and I would like to thank Ms. Oberkahn, Ms. Ezzo, and Mr. Irwin, and all of my teachers for helping me get through high school. It's been a great time.
I'd like to first of all thank my parents for motivating me and raising me to get to this point where I am today. And I'd also like to thank my teachers for allowing me to learn and also getting me here today. Thank you.
Let me let myself down, and I want to thank the boys. Thank you. Thank you.
I would like to thank my wonderful parents, my three pet lizards, Kimchi, Sprout, and Apricot, and my wonderful chicken and duck, Miss Cluck and Fireball, for being strange throughout the years and helping me.
Hello, everyone. It is my honor and pleasure to join you, although in a different way given our new reality. Today is truly a day to celebrate, to both look back and look ahead. It is also a time to acknowledge how much and how quickly our lives and world has changed since March. Of course, I wish I could be there in person, but that is not possible at this time. Graduating from high school is the culmination of many hours of hard work and perseverance. For the past quarter plus, you have navigated school closure, social distancing, the wearing of masks, and other precautions. It has been very hard. As you leave Tech Valley High School and prepare for the next phase of life's journey, I ask that you not dwell on the last portion of your senior year. Reflect on the 4 years of high school and how it supported your growth and prepared you to deal with life's unknown and real-world problems. Think about this for a moment. Consider how much you have grown since first stepping onto the College of Nanoscale Science and Engineering campus. You have become wiser, more confident, knowledgeable, and curious about learning. Throughout your career at Tech Valley, you had the chance to step outside the box and challenge yourself and others through group collaboration, public speaking, and interaction with business and industry professionals. You and your peers took advantage of project-based learning and what-if scenarios that have prepared you for what will come later in college, in the military service, and in life in general. But let's face it, some of it is known, but much of it is unknown, and you will manage. You left your home district to take classes on a college campus with students from other districts you didn't know, but who now have become lifelong friends. You graduated with college credits at a time when Americans are hurting financially and owe $1.6 trillion in student loans. Finally, you navigated uncertainty and dealt admirably with some harsh realities over the past 4 months. For that, I commend you. This is not the send-off you have been planning or dreaming of. But let me say this. You overcame adversity and found ways to preserve and succeed regardless of the hardships life has thrown to us. And you will be better for it. After all, this will not be your first or only setback. Life is full of challenges, from the workplace to our personal lives and personal relationships. You now have 17 or 18 years of experiences to celebrate and to draw from. But in many ways, life is truly just beginning for you. As we celebrate the Tech Valley High School Class of 2020, I also want to honor those who helped you reach this important milestone. They are your parents and guardians, family members, teachers, administrators, school staff, and friends. Please also think of the countless others who helped you from kindergarten to now, particularly staff from your home districts. In closing, I want you to know how proud we are of you and your classmates. Your experience will become part of history books, and you will be part of it. You endured and completed your senior year in an environment none of us had even imagined. Please continue to use your talents, knowledge, and experiences to make the world a better place for those who follow. We need you. I am excited about what you will each do next. Congratulations.
Congratulations. I am proud of all of you. Instead of sitting comfortably in your home district, chose the path thus taken, the way that challenged who you are and who you want to be. And you have succeeded. Take pride in the fact that during your time, you have fostered professional skills that will take you far in life. Through countless presentations, classmates, and business leaders, you have gained the ability to exchange ideas and communicate well, skills that are important in both business and in your personal life. As you move forward, I encourage you to never stop learning. Also bring with you on your life's journey the growth mindset you fostered in the classrooms and projects at Tech Valley High School. Never grow complacent with where you are, rather push forward to make choices that will not only lead to your future success and growth, but allow you to make your community and world a better place. Finally, I implore you to bring a positive outlook with you throughout your entire life. That outlook, while not easy to maintain, is a critical ingredient to success. Once again, congratulations, good luck, and stay healthy. I am proud of all of you.
Hello, everybody. On behalf of the co-presidents and the rest of the student body, we would like to congratulate the class of 2020.
We know this year has been challenging and incredibly difficult, but you did it. We have no doubt that every single one of you will do amazing things. Congratulations and best of luck, class of 2020.